Hi everyone, this is Ruturaj and welcome to our channel Joined. In today's video, we'll be looking at two very important things. One is balance sheet and another is debt score. Now let's start. What is a balance sheet? So balance sheet of a company records all these things: the shares, capital, reserves, borrowings, other liabilities, then fixed assets, capital work in progress, investments and other assets. So these four things, share capital, reserves, borrowings and other liabilities, are the total liabilities that the company is currently having. And fixed assets, capital work in progress, investments, other assets, these are the other total assets that the company has. So in balance sheet, you can see how the company is currently working. You can see what are the things that the company is investing, how much it is investing in capital work, or how much infrastructure work is being developed, how much borrowings the company has taken from the market, how much reserves the company has to pay back those borrowings, and how much share capital the company has, how much shares are open in the market, and how much share capital does the company have, and any other liabilities, and so on. So balance sheet basically tells you all the details that the company is currently having. So it is worth checking out this balance sheet of every company. Now let's see what is this debt score. So debt score simply means that what is the chance of bankruptcy. So it means what is the chance that a company can go bankrupt in, generally it is within two years. So debt score tells you that is there any chance of a company going bankrupt within the next 2 years. Now how it is calculated? It is calculated by using this formula, like 1.2a plus 1.4b plus 3.3c plus 0.6d plus e. What are a, b, c and d and e? A is working capital divided by total assets. B is retained earnings divided by total assets. C is earnings before interest and tax divided by total assets. D is market value of equity divided by total liabilities. And E is sales divided by total assets. So if you plug in all these A, B, C, D and E in this formula, you would get the debt score. Now if this debt score is greater than 2.99, then it is in, the company is in safe zone. If the debt score is between 1.8 and 2.99, then it is in gray zone. It might in future go to the bankruptcy, but currently it is in neutral state. If the debt score is below 1.81, then this indicates distress zone, or there is chance of bankruptcy in the company. So you should be very aware and cautious if you are investing in these companies. So this is a very important parameter, that is debt score. I hope this video is clear. In the next video, we'll be with some new concepts. Till then, take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.